Well, we now have the steeplechase. We've got three heats of that. So quite a big lineup, 13 men in each of three heats. And the qualifying conditions are that the first four in each heat and the next three will advance to the final. The world record still held by Saeed Chaif Shaheen, and this the Olympic record by Kariuki way back in 1988. Well, that's due for revision. I think there's every chance, Stuart, of that happening when we come to the final.
Yes, indeed. There is part of the lineup. Look for Mutai. There he is, the Kenyan. It's been dominated by the Kenyans over the years. And Kiplagat of Uganda, Nakisi of France. Let's look for Jaeger of the United States. He's got a good chance here. And we've got an Ethiopian in Mesfin, who is wearing the number 13, 1691. So all the ingredients are here. We shall just see who will prevail. Mesfin on the outside in that Ethiopian gear. There's Paulo of Portugal. Akdag there of Turkey. There's the American, Elvin Jager, who's got one of the fastest time at 8.06 here. So Jager should feature here if all goes well. The Tunisian, Nakisi, the Olympic silver medalist, twice European champion, 8.10.90 this year, 8.209 last year. Kiplagat, the Ugandan, also a very fine competitor. Remember, the first four, as Peter said, the first four to go through by right from this heat. Mulera, who's the Spanish, and there's Mutai, I mentioned him, Abel Mutai. He's the African champion this year, but only the Kenyan number three after Kipruto and Kemboi. What a reputation they have over the years of Olympic steeplechasing. They really do clean swept the Olympic decks on many occasions. So the 3000 meter steeplechase first heat underway, and we've just four places plus three fastest losers through due to Sunday's final, and we shall see how these are run. And of course, the advantage of competing in the third and final heat is that you pretty well know what the targets are for the fastest losers. So those who really want to commit and go into the next round really need to get into the first four. But Nakisi of France, the tall figure there, at one stage it looked as though he was going to take the European record. And Tari of France holds that in 8.118. It was a very good attempt, but didn't quite come off. He's the tall figure in second place. And really, it's not about times, this is about tactics, it's about being in the right place at the right time.
Well, certainly Abel Mutai, the Kenyan here, who won the Kenyan Olympic trials, just safely back, just in the pack there. And of course, a fascinating man to look for is Evan Jaeger, the American, who smashed the American record, improved his personal best by over 10 seconds when he was third in the Diamond League meeting in Monaco. That's Evan Jaeger of USA. At the moment, no particular need to push on, but they need to be aware that there are fastest times as well as the first four. So it's not only about getting fast four, but if you're not quite sure of yourself, well, you need to make sure it's a reasonably quick pace. But Mutai is certainly showing all the experience of the Kenyans, and he's just coming up to the lead now as the field just beginning, Stuart, to get stretched out a little bit, with the Ethiopian Mesfin also now in third place, and Arap Tani, of the Kiplagat rather, of Uganda, who's got a very good record in recent times, also prominent. So three of the main East African contenders at the head of the field now.
And in the high jump, we have a clearance from Fountain, who goes comfortably clear at 1.80 meters. Sorry, 1.83. That's the first time clearance. She said first time she's got a clean sheet. So 1.83, first time a clearance for Fountain from the US of A.
Well, certainly Kiplagat, Benjamin Kiplagat of Uganda, has taken this race on. Just getting a look at there. There are 28 barriers, 7 water jumps, and there's a faller there, and there are 2 fallers. The Spaniard has gone down.
Well, the Spaniards have brought down there.
Is that Paulo as well that's gone down? Sure. I think it is Paulo that's gone down. Yes, it is, the Portuguese. So certainly McHissey in second place. It seems to be winding it up just a little bit at the moment. Also, Mespin of Ethiopia is there too in fourth place. Haven't mentioned him. He's got a 8.20 time to his credit. But the fallers now have had a real disadvantage with Benjamin Kiplagat, the Ugandan record holder. He was ninth in the Beijing Olympic race, the man leading at the moment. He was only a junior then, got a world junior silver medal in 2008. You can see that they have a big gap now. He's certainly clear on qualifying. Akdag of Turkey is in second place. He's a transferee, formerly known as Patrick Kipkarui Langa, a Kenyan.
And Jager, the American, just behind him.
Yeah, Jager's American. The American, the tall figure with the headband, is behind him. Then Mespin, then Megisi. Behind him is Mutai. Then Ben Yahya of Tunisia. That's how they're stringing out now. That barrier causing a few problems. With just four laps to go in this first heat of the 3000 metre steeplechase. First four plus three fastest to Sunday's final. You mentioned Evan Yeager, the new North American record holder. His fifth ever 3000 metre steeplechase, and that's all happened since April 2012, just to re-emphasise that point. Because really he's a very confident young man. He's now in third place at the moment. So the leader is Akdag of Turkey. He's taken over with Kiplagat now in third place, Jaeger in second place.
Well, Akdag, when he was Patrick Langat of Kenya, was often employed as a pacemaker on the major events. So he's well used to leading, and he is indeed leading, with Jaeger looking good. Mutai also up there, the Kenyan, just biding his time back a little bit down the pack there. Now what, into fifth place, coming into fourth place, just ahead of the Tunisian.
Yeah, Mutai, the African champion this year. Only, as I said, the Kenyan number three. He's now moved into third place, pushing the long-time leader, the Ugandan, Kiplagat, now back into fourth place, ahead of Megisi. And then, of course, you've got Mespin behind him. And it will certainly start to wind up a little bit now with the first four places on offer, because there are still, what, two, four, six, eight involved in the race thus far. Rhythm sapping this with 28 barriers, seven water jumps. It really is testing for those who have been 1,500 metre men and moved up, and the 5,000 men have moved down. It's the rhythm sapping tenor of the race that causes the problems.
Well, there's the 2 kilometre split, 5:31.5, as these eight men have now opened up a very big gap of some 30 metres back to the ninth place. So the top four will come from these eight.
Akdag leads, Jaeger in second place, Mutai in third, McKissie in fourth, Alamri in fifth, Mespin in sixth, Benyai in seventh place. Coming up to two laps to go. Looks to me as though Jaeger's got a lot left in him, and I think this is going to be down to the sprint finish that we expected in, as a qualification. They don't want to work too hard on these, but at the same time, they've got to try and do the right thing. Jaeger now takes it over for the first time.
Well, this American really does look very impressive, doesn't he? The man who took 10 seconds off the American record, or 10 seconds off his best, to set an American record in Monaco. And he's got the confidence to take the lead in his first major championships in the Olympic final, with just a lap and a half to go now in the steeplechase.
Yeah, well, look, McKissie has moved up into second place just to cover Jaeger's move now as they go into the water jump again. Oh, Paula there as well. I tell you what, they're having real problems, aren't they? Jaeger leads, McKissie in second place, and then Mutai in third.
Akdag, I think it was, who fell. Was it? Oh, no, it's Mutai. No, Akdag, yeah.
Well, 400 metres to go, or the equivalent, one lap to go, I should say. Jaeger leads, McKissie in second place, Mutai in third place, and behind Mutai is Akdag.
Well, actually, it was Kiplagat, I think, who fell and has gone back into the lineup now.
300 metres to go. Two barriers, one water jump, And I tell you, the Evan Jaeger has really stretched them out down the back straight, and I think the battle's going to be for the third, for the fourth and fifth place rather, or who can get into the first four, obviously. So Jaeger's going to qualify, McKissie looks as though he's going to qualify, Mutai putting a little bit of pressure on, just stumbling a little bit out of that, but those three are away. Akdag, it is in fourth place at the moment. Akdag's got the fourth place qualifier at the moment. So Jaeger, McKissie, Mutai and Akdag as they go into that barrier. And they're going to be the four qualifiers by right. And there's McKissie actually comes through to win it. But they're the four qualifiers. No real problems there. And 8:16.24. Actually, it was quite a good good race in the end. 8:16.24 is a respectable time. Certainly in a heat. And they all looked pretty easy to me as the tail enders come in. One or two of the fallers early on, of course, who persevered with the race. Mulera of Spain was one of the fallers. We saw him go down, and he's just finished.
And Paula of Portugal as well, yeah.
The time. Job done. And I say that Evan Jaeger had a lot left in the tank, didn't he? And when you've got an eight best of 8.06, then really there is a lot left in the tank. There's 10 seconds or more. But it looks as though he's come to these championships in very good order indeed. Almost clears the whole of that water jump off the barrier. There's the faller.
That was Kiplagat,
yeah,
who got up in the end and came sixth.
And it is three fastest to the final. Eight. Now, just let's make a note of that, 8:16.24.
Yeah, it was quite a quick heat. I mean, Mesfin just came through with a... See the spirited finish there. Mesfin, the Ethiopian, just coming past to take fifth place, just ahead of Kiplagat. But they ran 8:18.16 and 8:18.44. Pretty useful times. Very experienced, isn't he, McKissie Benabad? He came through and just took it on the line, but he didn't exert himself any more than necessary. But he remains the top European with the absence through injury this year of Tari, and he will be the man really to perhaps best contend with the Kenyans when it comes to the final. Meanwhile, Dobrinska.
Yeah, Dobrinska in the high jump. She's had a first-time failure at 183, but she nails it on a second attempt. And Dobrinska goes clear at 1.83 meter. So a little hiccup on the first attempt, but that's a very clean execution of a high jump. And she applauds herself. That was a very nice second attempt clearance for Dobrinska.
As we look back on the finish this race, I must say I was very impressed with Jaeger. He really is a new talent that the Americans have found here. And he just jogged in behind McKissie Benabad.
Let's confirm all of that. McKissie Benabad, 8:16.23. Evan Jaeger, Abel Mutai, and Tariq Akdag. They're the four qualifiers by right. And Mesfin, Kiplagat, and Yaya must wait with those three fastest times. As I said to you, the other heats will benefit because they will know what the targets are.
They don't always necessarily follow that, though, for all that they should do. His first Olympics.
Yeah.
So we've got two more heats of the steeplechase, both again with 13 men fields. The heptathlon high jump, still two pools, 183 is the height.
Yeah, Chinova coming in for a final attempt at 1.83 meter. She started off at 1.74. She's worked her way up to 1.83. Her first attempt was not as sharp as she would like. She wants the crowd to help, and apart from slapping her legs to get the blood flowing, she now wants the crowd to help her get over 183, and they're responding. So, great crowd in the stadium here this morning. But, very flat. Didn't really look as if she was going to come in and attack the bar. Sort of almost slow into the takeoff area. You can see her leaning away slightly from the takeoff area. She comes in and just goes flat over the bar and knocks it down on the way through. So Chinova goes out at 183.
Well, 180 is not a disaster for her because this is not one of her best events, but she'll lose much more ground to Ennis now. So not so good for the world champion, but not an absolute disaster because her best ever is 187, so she's not so far away.
No, and what we need now is for Ennis to go higher and higher.
Well, we'll see how that progresses as we now look across the field for the second race in the steeplechase. So we're flashing across Getahun of Ethiopia, Brimin Kipruto of Kenya, the defending champion, Talib of Morocco, Keskisalo of Finland, Arap Thani of Uganda, Floriani of Italy, Abdi of Australia, Bazan of Peru, Olcorn of USA, Chavkin of Russia, Zouai Dondria of France, Merzigui of Spain, and Kosinov of Kazakhstan. That's the full lineup. As I say, the number one name there, the man who's been second and first in the last two Olympics, Brimin Kipruto of Kenya. Kenya having won the last seven editions of the Olympic steeplechase. And twice on those occasions, they have also gone 1, 2, 3. So we're looking now at Abdel Aziz Merzigui, former world junior finalist, and he was fourth a couple of years ago, so an up-and-coming youngster, 8.18.03. Panning across the rest of the lineup, there's the American Alcorn past Bazan. But now let's have a look at Floriani of Italy, and then Arap Thani of Uganda. Well, concentrating on him, he's a man who loves to set the pace. He was sixth in the World Championships last year, did a lot of the work in the qualifying rounds. Keskisalo of Finland, a former European champion. Then we have Brahim Taleb of Morocco, who's got a best of 8.07.02, making him the second quickest in this lineup. And here's the man who is the quickest in the lineup. He's one of the fastest in the field. Indeed, he missed the world record last year by just 1/100th of a second, and that's Brimin Kipruto. Hasn't broken 8 minutes this year, but he's such a talent that he could do so when it comes to a major occasion. 7:53.64 is his personal best. 8:01.73 this year. Brimin Kipruto with the tradition of Kenyan steeplechasing behind him. Heat two. Well, off they go. 13 men with 4 men to go through to the final, together with the next 4 fastest. No one setting off at a particularly outrageous pace at this stage. The competition, early stages of course, with 7.5 laps of the track. Floriani of Italy, the Russian Chavkin just settling in second place there now. And right on the outside, Kipruto making sure that there's no trouble for him. So too Arap Thani of Uganda and the Ethiopian Getahun. So the East Africans keeping out of trouble on the outside of this race, making sure they've got enough space, of course, when it comes up to the barriers to have a clear attempt. Don't want fallers in the early stage as we had in the previous heat. But they are now getting just a little bit strung out now as they've gone through the first lap here in this second race. Well, Arap Thani of Uganda loves to lead, and he's now coming to the fore as he's overtaking Floriani.
Yes, indeed. It's they've got a target of 8:16.24, the fastest losers here. But you'll always find that the Kenyans will be in the right place at the right time when it matters. They have such an expertise in this event. Arap Thani, Keskitalo is there, as you said. And then Chavkin, the Russian, half-marathon specialist. 63 minutes a half-marathon. 8:26 is steeplechase. And I have to say that Kipruto looks very, very easy indeed. He's in about, 2, 4, 6, 7, but always on the outside.
And the French girl, Dijmund, fails at 183. And again, she sort of snakes across the high jump run-up and then cuts back in sharply. And it worked for her on a third attempt at 180, but 183, she goes out of this high jump in the heptathlon. Yozipenko coming up for her second attempt at 183. In comparison, a much shorter run-up, but coming up with the same The same detail in terms of the jump. She goes third failure on 183. Didn't get high enough and came down on that bar. So, oh, that was her second attempt. So second failure at 183.
Well, meanwhile, Araptani still leads the steeplechase, but Brimim Kavruto so smoothly moved up through the field just a half a lap ago and has now come into third place in this race as they go through the first kilometre just outside 250. So that's only 8:30 pace. So they're not taking much heed of the fact that there were some quite quick times in fifth and sixth in the previous race. They all think they can get into the first four, but certainly the pace will be increasing a little bit now with Araptani of Uganda, who's a determined front runner, and he's in the lead there now. But as I say, Kipruto looked pretty good having moved up into third place.
And let's not forget Brahim Taleb either, who's also moved up into that leading, he's in what, fifth place at the moment, just settling in, and he's got a pedigree as well. 8.7 his personal best, 8.10 this year, he's 27 now, but very experienced, and experience does tell in this competition, in the Olympic Games, it certainly does.
So it's the two East Africans now who head this field. It's Araptani of Uganda ahead of Kipruto of Kenya, the defending champion.
Yusuf Abdi, of course, moved up there, the Australian, the Commonwealth Games bronze medalist back in 2002. He's competed. I saw him in the Diamond League in Monaco. He was 10th in that race, so, you know, found that a bit tough, but that was a race where they were running well close to 8 minutes flat, and it was very much a paced race.
But he's proved himself to be a big meeting competitor. He was sixth in Beijing, of course. So that's Abdi of Australia we're talking about as we go back to the high jump.
And Yossi Pinko comes back for a third attempt, and she goes over the bar at 183. So third attempt, two failures, and she came in for a third attempt, and she goes clear. The arms go up. She's delighted with that. So a clearance at 183 for Yossi Pinko. And Fountain coming up for her first attempt at 186. And she goes clear. She rattles it a little bit. You can see it vibrating in the stand. But Fountain of America goes clear at 1 meter 86. A very good clearance on her first attempt. Nice curve on the run-up as she comes in and gets nice, a good position at that takeoff point. Although she does catch it with the shoulders, she glides over with a slight touch and it stays up. So she'll be pleased with that attempt, that's for sure. So, good clearance. She's got a clean clearance sheet, clear at every first attempt all the way through.
Well, we're coming back to the steeplechase, coming up to the 2,000 metre point, and we have Araptani of Uganda who leads. In second place is Kipruto of Kenya. Then we have Taleb of Morocco and Abdi of Australia. Zoe Dondrieu of France has also moved up in that little leading group. He's in sixth place at the moment. And 2:51, the second kilometre, so it remains slow.
Yeah, it does. 11 seconds slower than the first heat. So, you know, the point I make about fastest qualifiers is valid here, because unless they really motor, but have come down the straight and they will see that there's a straightway and two laps to go in this 3,000 meter steeplechase. And 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 men in contention now, and someone soon is going to start moving. But Kipruto, look at that, beautifully poised right on the outside, not trapped, in good form.
So two laps to go in the second heat of the steeplechase, and we've got Kipruto of Kenya and Araptani of Uganda heading a group of nine men there. Floriani of Italy has been prominent throughout, he's still up there. So too is Taleb of Morocco, with Abdi just passing him now into fourth place, but with only four short to go through. And this is a slowly run race, so we're not looking for any more than the four, I don't think. There are still nine men in that leading group with just a lap and a half to go, but the dominant force nonetheless are the East Africans, until the burst through. Yusuf Abdi of Australia has now burst into the lead, coming up to the penultimate water jump in this race. But behind him, it's Kipruto of Kenya, who's shown plenty of friskiness there in moving up quickly behind Abdi. Then we have Taleb, then we have Araptani, then Floriani, and then the Russian Chavkin, as they're getting the clear of the rest of the field now. So, coming up to the bell, first four to go through. It's Abdi who leads, Kipruto in second place, Taleb in third. Then we have Floriani, but there's still nine men in contention for the top four spots here. Araptani just dropping back a little bit, the Ugandan who was bombed earlier, but now as I say that, he just moves up to hurdle that place, but he's in sixth place now. It's Abdi who's leading on. Kipruto now ranging up ahead of him. And it is still coming up to 200 metres to go. And the favourite, the defending champion, Kipruto. Floriani running tremendously well for Italy is now into second. Abdi just behind him, then Taleb, then Chavkin, and these four getting away from the rest of the field now as Araptani is struggling. So coming into the home straight now, we have the favourite, the defending champion, Kipruto of Kenya, coming over the final hurdle. Floriani looks round. Yusuf Abdi is fading backwards a bit now as it's Taleb coming through, and also Keskisalo taking through, and they're the first four. It's slow, it's only 8:30 pace, so only the first four there. And must say, Keskisalo, the former European champion, ran a nicely judged race to come up into the first four there. Abdi faded badly, so too did Araptani, but Kipruto had no trouble.
Yeah, you're right about Abdi, tripped over the last barrier. He really almost went down. He almost stopped and the momentum has gone, and so is his race. He was in a good position at the right time, but unfortunately couldn't quite manage it when it mattered, really. There's a faller as well.
Getahun of Ethiopia spread-eagled on the track, unfortunately. No trouble at all for this man.
Well, he looks as I hope the medic. Yes, the medics are getting across to him right now, just off your shot, as we watch the final stages of this second heat. And Floriani of Italy going very strongly indeed. Look at that. There was almost a fall there by Keskitalo. He survived that one, almost tripped over the barrier. Now watch Abdi on the last barrier. Watch him. There. He almost stumbles and falls over and loses his momentum completely. So at the end of that.
So that's it. That's Kipruto, Floriani, Taleb and Keskisalo, the men who qualify. Chavkin in fifth won't, nor will Abdi or Araptani.
Well, Keskitalo almost stumbled on the last bend as well. At last, they're getting some attention to the faller. And let's hope that Getahun of Ethiopia is not too badly hurt. He was the African Games champion last year. So looking at his time, he's an 8:18 this season, so he would have been in contention at his best. But thankfully, they've now got the attendance that he deserves.
And Ennis has her second attempt at 186, and she thought she got clear, but her heels just clipped the bar, and as she was going to get up to celebrate, the bar came down. So, well, she didn't catch it with her heels. She just caught it with her buttocks. So I think she's got enough energy in her to perhaps have a better attempt at that. But two failures at 1.86 meters.
Yes, well, after that brilliant hurdles, she can afford perhaps a little bit less in the high jump, but this is disappointing if she doesn't get more. But we're coming back to the hammer again.
Yeah, in the hammer, we have Group B now. This starting about half an hour late. The first group with that rain sort of stopped things happening in the speed that you would like it to happen. So we have the Group B that has 21 competitors in the event, and the first up is James Stacey from Canada, and the list is just coming up here. You can see that there's a selection of countries entering into this competition, and we have Paz of Hungary in this group. Ukrainian Rubanko and holding up the bottom of the field and going 21st is Figueres from France.
There's Ezekiel Kemboi of Kenya, twice world champion after three successive silvers. He goes in the final heat of the 3,000-metre steeplechase. And we already have eight qualifiers by right.
Well, meanwhile, here's the result of the second heat of the steeplechase. Brimming Kipruto winning in 8:28.62. Floriani, Taleb and Keskisalo also going through to the semi-finals. But it was a slowly run race, so it'll only be those four. Getahun having the misfortune to fall on the last lap and get carried off in a wheelchair. Let's hope he recovers quickly. Well, one heat left in the steeplechase, and there indeed is the lineup for that final heat.
Yes, indeed, Belabas of Algeria. There, Gari has been going well. Famous name, Gebre Selassie. Not that one, though. There's Ezekiel Kemboi and Hamid Ezine in Morocco. One or two names that are related to more famous names. The younger brother of the world silver medalist, Ali, is Hamid. There he is, right on the outside on cue. Best of what, 8:16.93? 8:09 is personal best, but 8:16 this season, or thereabouts. Just being introduced to the crowd. Cabral, the American. I don't have to tell you there's British interest in the background as we greet Ezekiel Kemboi. Kemboi, one of the greats, and I use that word advisedly, 7:55.76 is personal best. There's Stuart Stokes of Great Britain. And the Eritrean, Gebre Selassie. There's Roba Gari. Gari, the Ethiopian record holder. The atmosphere is absolutely electric. Victor Garcia. Just waiting for the starter to call them forward.
On your marks.
Once again, they get underway pretty quickly to get settled into their running. And now steadying it down. So this will be in favour of the first four, certainly not in favour of the fastest losers. They really know that they've got, they know what the target is, really, they'll have been told. But Cabral it is that leads, as you can see, Garcia, the Spaniard, in the middle of that rod, so is just looking across Gari, Roba Gari, the Ethiopian record holder up there as well.
And as we've seen many times before, Ezekiel Kemboi plays around with these fields sometimes. He's right at the back, but we've seen many times him come through when he needs to. Certainly Gari is a very consistent strong runner, the Ethiopian there in second place. He's broken 8:10 several times, 8:06.16 this year. And Kemboi still not taking any interest in it.
Well, he must be about 30 or 40 yards behind the leader Cabral, the American, who's the collegiate champion last season. It's Princeton University, I'm told. 8:19.14 is best set this year. And the American steeplechasers have come on rather well this year. So in second place is Gari, and the Spaniard in third place, that's Garcia.
And coming in for her second attempt at 1 meter 86, Katarina Johnson-Thompson. composing herself at the start of a run-up. And she goes down, and the crowd goes wild. So Katarina Johnson-Thompson goes clear, the first appearance on her second attempt at 1m86. Good run-up, attacks the bar, gets into that zone where you've got to put your foot down and take off, and she gets up off that takeoff foot and converts that speed into the bar, into the vertical lift that she's looking for. So second round clearance, and Ennis goes for her third attempt, and she goes clear too. So 1.86 for Ennis on her third attempt. So both Britons clear at 1.86.
Well, that's a bit of relief there for Ennis, because she is the British record holder at 1.95, and at 1.86 should be routine. Took three attempts, but he looked pretty happy with that one.
And so she should be.
Steeplechase now coming towards the mid part of the race, and no real change at all, really. The American quite keen to take the pace. He's doing a good pacemaking job, actually, at the front, as Don Cabral. Almost a little stumble there in the background. I'm just looking right second from the back now is the man who really should come through and prevail here, Ezekiel Kemboi, twice the world champion, former Olympic champion, former Commonwealth champion. He's been there or thereabouts all the way in his career. He's one of a great band. Stuart Stokes is the Briton who's way off the back of this group, really.
He's coming through, charging past the rest of the field. He does this so often. There's no need to worry about Kemboi if you see him lagging at the back of a field. It really isn't, because he's done this time and time again. But Cabral and Gari at the head of the field have been running very well, and it's a quicker pace than we saw in Heat 2, at least. I'm not quite sure whether it's as quick as Heat 1 yet. We'll take a check on that, of course, when we come in elapsed time to the 2-kilometre point. There's the Spaniard, Vitor Garcia, very promising youngster in the event now, the Spaniard, who's now back in fourth place, as Cabral continues to do an excellent job of leading this field on.
Yes, he does. They're looking for, well, the first heat was the fastest, certainly at 5:31.5, our next checkpoint at 2 kilometres, so we shall see, but certainly no change. Gari in second, Bellabas in third, and here comes Kemboi now into, what, fifth place, just lining himself up for that barrier, and now moving up very steadily. As he sees, there are three laps to go, or three turns of this track to go. They're not exactly 400 metre laps, but there are three rounds of the course to go.
And Paschinski, the Pole in the white vest, is also prominent there in fifth place now. But it's coming up now to the 2 kilometre point. That first heat, 5:31.5, so we'll keep a check on that as they come up to this point to see how well Cabral's been doing here right at the forefront of the field. Well, it's a little past it, a little slower perhaps.
Well, we're looking for one, yeah, but it's 5 seconds slow. It's 5 seconds slower than the first heat, so really they've got to motor now in the final 1,000 metres that certainly the fastest losers have, and I think the tenor of the race will start to develop now. Everyone clear in that water jump as they come into the straight again, and they will look to the board and see that we've got two laps to go in this 3,000 metre steeplechase. Bellabas in third place, Kemboi now in fourth place, just settling, very happy to settle in there.
Just behind him is Ezine of Morocco in the red vest there. But there's now a group of nine men. The Pole Parzynski now in eighth place, dropping back a little bit relatively. Vitianov of Moldova also up there.
Well, Bellabas moving up quite nicely in that leading group. Just looking to see who else is up there. 2.482 is the, and that's Lucianov of Moldova, who's now into second place or third place now, being run down a little bit as they move into that water jump. Almost a stumble there. So they're really beginning to motor now, as they'll see the one marker as the American now accelerates again. So Cabral has led all the way through this. Kemboy in second place, Belabas in third, then Ezin in fourth place, Lucianov of Moldova, the Moldovan record holder, the European Championship bronze medalist in 2010, so he's got a bit of a pedigree. He's in fourth place now, just ahead of Robagari. Robagari in the green and red of Ethiopia as they motor down the back straight now. And it's Belabas who's leading them now. Here comes Gary Roby. And Ezin now, as they got 200 metres to go. Kemboy leads. In second place, all of a sudden, Robagari, the Ethiopian record holder. He's in second place. Belabas is in third place. Ezin is in fourth place as they really motor down towards the finish. Cabral, who's done most of the work in this race, now finds himself in fifth place. Well, now he's back in fourth, and that really deserves that. Gary wins it. Kemboy in second place. Ezin. And, well, I tell you what, that was an extraordinary move, right out to the outside, jogged through the line. And didn't worry, but the first four absolutely clear there. Cabral coming through as well. So he deserved to get his place, didn't he?
He did indeed, because he did a lot of work there. 8:20.68. So remember, we've got a couple of times in the sub 8:20 in that first race, fifth and sixth. They'll go through now. They can be rest assured that they did enough. But Kemboy treated this race with disdain almost.
Yes, he did. He got second place. He moved out so wide we couldn't quite see where he'd come. It is 8:20.97 second place. And Garcia, the Spaniard, was the man not to finish in this. But Robagari was always there or thereabouts, dropped back a little bit towards the final stages of the race, but then came back into it with Ezin and Belabas. And I'm glad in a way that Cabral got his place. Belabas was the man to suffer. Watch him off this barrier, really struggling. He was very tired. Look at that. His legs almost gave way under him and allowed Cabral to come through to take the fourth place. Look at this from one of the favourites. The Kenyans truly dominate this event. It's astonishing, really. Robagari wins it comfortably, but look at this on the near side. Yeah, done it with the least possible damage to the physiology.
Well, Kemboy's got a wonderful record over the years in the steeplechase, and when it comes to a major championships, he's always proves he's there and he's ready, and it looks like he is this time. So we're just down to the top competitors in the high jump, but meanwhile,
just confirm that win by Robagari and Ezekiel Kemboy in second place, Hamid Ezin in third, and Donald Cabral in fourth. And Lucianov qualifies the fastest loser in that heat, so he did well actually, because most of the others, all the others, came from heat one, which was the fastest heat overall. Here are the rest of the times.
And Ennis back at the high jump, 189. Oh, ow, it came down again, similar to one of her attempts at 186, where she just seems to clip it. It seems to stay there, tantalise the crowd into thinking it's going to stay up. And it just trickles down off those stands, and she opens her mouth in disbelief. Oh, the crowd going.
Wonderful reaction from the crowd there. They're living every moment with Jessica Ennis. They really are.
And that's her second failure at 189.
Well, there's the confirmation of the people who have qualified for the steeplechase final. That list headed by the winner of Heat 1, Nahedine Mekissi-Benabad of France, 8:16.23. That was quick. A couple of little cues there, 8:18 times qualify. But those are the men we'll see in the final. So, as expected, the three Kenyan favourites safely through. And indeed, no major shocks in that event.